Pure. See, the world really needs all the people like me. See how bad it could actually be.
Yo, what's happening, YouTube Jugger here? Welcome back to another video.
Man, I'm so sorry for the late, extremely late upload this weekend. Been doing so many giveaways and giving back so much of real stuff in real life, and even giving my time willingly so you guys can have a great time in real life, whether it be giving away money or consoles or new generation stuff. It's all for you. But now, guess what? We have the time to actually make this video so you guys can see this weekend items. Just so you guys know that we will not be continuing this cycle of uploading weekend items on Sunday. The shop is now closed, but because, like I said, the work schedule has been so crazy and hectic that I finally have time to actually make this video now. But it will actually be like this maybe once in a while, but we are gonna go back to regularly scheduled upload starting this week for Thanksgiving. And I'm so thankful for each and every one of you. You guys really brighten my day and give me the necessary energy that I need to continue the grind. Just so you guys know as well, the Evervescent theme animations on my videos for these loot item videos will be this coming weekend as well. Just so you guys know, I had a delay with the original designer and getting that to me, so I'm still working on actually upping the amazing things that you guys see on my channel when it comes to graphics and animations. Continuously working. Okay, so let's get into this weekend items, which is actually this past Friday to right now. So let's get caught up together. Now, these are 12 brand new items that I handcrafted for you guys. Like I said, the shop is closed right now, but these items will be returning this weekend. So if you miss your chance to get it this weekend, you can actually get it next weekend, along with the brand new sets of some amazing new elemental items that I'm making just for next weekend, so you guys can have fun. So we're bringing back these and some new ones, so it's gonna be amazing holiday coming up this weekend for everyone in the shop. All right, so let's take a look at the brand new first sets of class mods for the fourth skill tree for all characters. All right, remember guys, you can only get these class mods, the base class mods, in Arms Race, but I actually pulled it out and actually got it for you guys and actually combined it with other class mods in the game and made this amazing fourth skill tree class mods for all characters: Mo, Zane, Flak, and Amara. And you guys are looking at the four skill tree right now, and I actually overcharged, supercharged each fourth skill tree for each individual character for their fourth skill tree class mod. How cool is that?
That's
I appreciate you. Well, you guys are probably like, Jug, what do you mean by you overcharge, supercharge the fourth skill tree class mod? What I actually mean by that is a couple of things. First of all, the blue square neon box you guys are seeing above the skill points, even though there are no skill points that you put into that skill point, I actually put skill points into that neon box, and those skills are actually activated, which is super amazing. And not only that, you can actually overcharge it. So if it says slash whatever out of one, you can actually go to 2, 3. Actually, you can actually go to 12 out of 3. And some of them, if you want, so you can actually overcharge that ability to get more power to have more fun in the game. So I actually gave you guys the freedom to have so much fun with the fourth skill tree class mod. So go out there if you have it right now and mess with it and see what you can actually do. And those extra skill points you can actually put in other trees if you would like, because guess what? I already covered you with those extra skill points in your fourth skill tree class mod. Next up, we have the brand new Beskar shield. Now, I do like the design on this shield especially, and you guys will have tons of fun with this shield. I actually overcharged this shield as well with over 127k in capacity. You guys will actually love this shield, especially if you're looking for something with power, ability, and high amounts of capacity, especially with that recharge ability. Boom, break charge right back up instantaneously. Next up, we have the Spark Plug Holy Grail artifact. Now, this thing is really, really cool. Now, you guys already know what the Holy Grail does, because this is a DLC 5 Season Pass 2
item combined with the spark plug.
Now, I wasn't focusing on slam abilities with this artifact. In particular, I actually wanted it to harness your class mods and your shield. As you guys can see, with this artifact attached to me, look how much damage I can actually take without actually taking damage itself, which is really, really, really
cool.
Now,
I'm going to actually slam and show you guys the power of this brand new spark plug combined with the Holy Grail. Now, boom, electric arc effect, lightning, chain into nearby enemies. They try to jump me together, they die together upon my slam. So amazing with this artifact. Now, like I said, I made this artifact to harness your class mod, your shield, and also one more thing, which is your grenade mod. So this is actually the foundation of your build if you have all 12 of these items, because this is where the harness of the power lays within the relic to give you guys extra abilities for your class mod, shield, and grenade mod.
Next up, let's actually take a look at the brand new hot spring expansive grenade mod. Now, I decided to show you guys exactly how this works while using Zane, because I know in the past I gave you guys the ability to use my crazy grenade mods with Zane, and some of you guys really didn't like it because how OP it was on Zane, and Zane just actually throws out random grenades here and there from his drone if you're using that action skill. So I did not want to actually overcharge your game per se, so you lag or whatever the case may be. I wanted to actually give you guys a little bit more control so you can actually have fun if you're playing with Zane with this grenade mod, and at the same time still make it work for other characters. So this is actually really more balanced with a slight OP to give every single character more of a fun factor in the game.
Ah, that's cool. Nice. Real nice.
Well, I appreciate it, Queen. And shout out to your girl Glitching Queen for actually hitting 1 million subscribers last night. Super amazing. And we will actually have something amazing for her in the shop as well for you guys coming up this week in celebration of hitting her 1 million subscriber goal. All right, just really quickly before we move on to the other weapon for Mose, you guys are looking at here right now, just want to let you guys know that the grenade mod is an electric arc grenade mod. You guys can see just now actually how it works. Just throw it a whole bunch of hot springs that heals you, pops out of those electric arcs, then bursts into electricity throughout the air. Drop more grenade mods on the floor while activating more hot springs to heal you and your friends. Yes, it actually heals your friends as well at the same time. How cool is that?
That's hot.
Next up, we actually have Mosey's weapon right here. You guys are looking at the Rebound COV assault rifle, which actually shoots out. Remember that time that I actually made that artifact that when you slam or slide, it actually shoots out this actual buzzsaw with C4 attached to it for Krieg right before the DLC actually dropped? Well, now I actually got a weapon and made a weapon that actually does the same exact thing, except it's actually elemental and it shoots out buzzsaw that actually has grenades and C4 attached to it that actually explodes on impact. And if you want more skill damage and point damage, all you gotta do with weapon damage, all you gotta do is activate your action skill. You guys see my iron cup there going crazy ham, and you guys will get bonus stats with this weapon because I actually added the brand new anointments on this weapon for Mosey from season pass 2. How cool is that?
Next up, we have the trick shot Bloodstained version 2 for Flak.
Now you guys are like, Jug, why is there a version 2? What happened to version 1? First of all, we're going to get to that in this part of the video talking about that and exactly how you're actually going to get a free item from this item right here, which is actually super amazing, way better than version 1. But first of all, let's talk about the design.
Now, I actually removed the mag, which actually gives this weapon unlimited ammo, which is a plus. But I actually do like it, having a hole in the gun, because it looks super different than what you're used to seeing, and I think it actually looks badass. You really can't tell when you're in first person mode that there's a missing mag, which is also cool because you can actually see the bullets on the gun more, and it's actually illuminated to match the element of radiation.
Now, there's a big difference between version 1 and version 2, and yes, some people actually got version 1, and we're gonna talk about what the heck happened to version 1.
Well, version 1 actually performed amazingly well,
called Juin Testing on PC, but once it got ported over to console, it was actually lackluster. And you guys know, I cannot give you guys something that actually underperforms. I actually take pride in my crafts, and I want you guys to have the most fun in the game with my items. So I actually went back and fixed it and made a version 2. Now I'm going to tell you exactly how you're going to get version 2 for free if you actually purchase version 1.
Now version 1 actually has a damage of 300k, to whereas version 2 actually has a damage of 700k, which is a big upgrade. Version 1 does have Flax Season Pass 2 anointments. Version 2 has it as well, but I decided to add that 50 over 150 bonus radiation damage that you guys love so much, and that is added to version 2 along with those brand new Flak anointments, and at the same time has unlimited ammo, and at the same time is tri-elemental. So not only you're doing radiation, but I actually put bonus elemental damage with other elements on this weapon for your fun. Very, very super sexy.
Oh my god, that hot.
Okay, so if you purchase version 1 of this weapon in the shop this weekend, tonight my little nephew is actually delivering version 2 to everyone who bought version 1 a free copy. He's giving out a free copy to everyone who bought version 1 tonight of version 2. So check your inbox, your in-game mail, and tonight by 7 o'clock p.m. PST time, everyone will have their new copy of version 2 of the Trick Shot if you purchase version 1 in the shop, as a bonus for me actually giving it to you guys and working extremely more hard to make sure that you have more fun in this game. So if it's broken or it's not working properly or intended, I will go back and fix it and make sure you guys get a free copy always. And this is something else that I do extra for you. Also, make sure that your hot fixes are applied while using version 2 of the weapon. And if you have any problem with damage scaling, please see the FAQ section in my shop for more additional details.
Next up, we actually have the superconducting plasma coil for your girl Amaro, which actually has a brand new phase flare anointment from season pass 2 built into this weapon, along with her phase slam, phase grass, and phase cast, along with brand new astral projection abilities from season 2 built into this brand new plasma coil for her, and at the same time enhancing her cryo abilities with this weapon, because now you know that her first skill tree has cryogenic abilities, so this weapon actually harnesses into it and give her extra power. And I did not want to stop there. I actually put incendiary damage on here to balance it out so you guys can have fun if you're fighting an enemy that is actually flesh. But I do love the cryogenic on this weapon because it has all of that power built into it. What the heck? Who just took me down?
That's not hot.
But I'm actually going to switch back to my cryogenic like I told you about that power. And I'm going to go ham, and you guys will see the power that actually lays within this weapon for the simple fact of that brand new cryogenic plasma coil ability that gives Amara that true complete siren power while using this weapon and enhances her cryogenic ability.
Really, really, really fun weapon. Now let's take a look at the next weapon, which is going to be for Zany.
Next up, we have the brand new Super Frozen Creeping Death XL for Zany. You guys will love this weapon because it has his brand new abilities for his plasma cannon, along with other abilities for his other action skill built into this one weapon. And once you use this with that Zany class mod, you're going to be in for such a treat, and I'm going to tell you guys why. Now check this out. I'm shooting this enemy right here, and I'm going to just go ham. Oh my god, what? Who just hit me like that?
That's not hot.
Tell him, queen. Oh, now we're going to get back up, and we're going to actually show you the power of this weapon together, and no one will ever take me down again.
Let's take a look at this weapon closely. So we're gonna slow it down. You guys can see once I shoot this weapon, bubbles come out of this weapon in corrosive splatter effect, which is actually really cool.
And the little grenade pods that actually come out of it, surrounded by this poisonous gas, is really cool. And at the same time, it actually explodes into cryogenic blast and ice and snow and everything, and actually has a really cool sound effect. And it sounds like
okay. If you're not having fun with this game, then I do not know what you're doing, and I always want to create new
creative ways and experiences for you guys to have fun and new ways to play in. And you guys will actually accomplish that with this weapon. So let's continue talking about more with this weapon other than the crazy sound effect and the ability of the little grenade pods with the poisonous gas and the grenade corrosive splatter. But let's talk about what actually happens when you reload.
So upon reloading, you guys will actually throw out a copy, four copies of this weapon that shoots every single element in the game, looking like a little firework right there. Little firework show, really, really awesome, visually stunning power. This weapon has it all for Zane, and it has the brand new anointments, like I said, for Zane in Season Pass 2. And there goes the Hot Springs grenade mod going off as well, working beautifully while paired with that creepy shotgun for Zane.
Next up, we have your brand new FAMS weapon. Now, you guys already know I'm the creator of FAMS. Now, FAMS mean Flak, Amara, Moze, and Zane weapon, because all of those character anointments are built into one item. So you guys are looking at Iron Cub, Shoulder Cannon, Gravity Snare, and Phase Flare FAMS, FAMZ, Flak, Amara, Moze, and Zane weapon. And this is it right here, your OPQ portals and shite. And I actually brought it for you guys so you guys can have tons of fun with this weapon, which is super OP, because I wanted you guys to have a weapon that harnesses the power of every single character for their fourth skill tree while giving you fun with an elemental shock, which is actually OP. And at the same time, down on the D-pad, we'll replicate a copy of this weapon, shooting it out, throwing it out. You guys can see right here, which is the OPQ system side of the weapon, and it will go around helping you to kill enemies really fast, because I want you guys to have fun as well with an OP weapon. So this is slightly more OP to balance out your fun, so you can have extreme amounts of new creative ways to play if you collected all 12 of these items, because I don't want every single item feeling the same. I want to have every item to have their own personality trait, so you guys can have different experiences. And that's one of the ways that I handcraft for you.
Now, if you want more power with this weapon, all you gotta do is activate your action skill, and of course this weapon will increase by 100% alongside with your other anointments from Season Pass 2. Will all stack, and you guys will have so much more fun for a short time, and then it will reset. And then activate your action skill again if you're looking for that extreme amount of power, so you guys can actually balance it out for yourself. If you want to use it or not, it is there for you. So you have complete control of this weapon and your fun in this
game. Now, I didn't really get a lot of time to actually speak about the grenade mod, but you can throw as many of this grenade mod that you will like in your game on console, and it will not crash. How cool is this? Looking like a firework show hot spring that you can actually take a bath in with all of your friends. Wait, hold up.
Giveaway time. Now, you guys already know we have 12 new items this weekend, and I'm giving away 3 of these items. You can mix and match as you please, so pick any 3 and let me know in the comment section. First come, first serve to the first 3 people on PlayStation and the first 3 people on Xbox. Let me know which 3 items you would like, and I will actually send them to you for free for just subscribing to me and having notifications turned on, and I totally appreciate you.
And if you actually miss your chance to get it for free, you can always purchase it in my item shop, which is actually now closed, and which will actually be opening, reopening with the brand new items along with these 12 new items this weekend on Thanksgiving Day. So many treats, so many things to be thankful for, and I'm super thankful for you. So if you want it, it's there available for you guys coming up. So until next time, remember, treat yourself, don't cheat yourself. I'm Jug, love you guys to the fullest, and I'll see you here for another one.
Just go let the credits roll. Hey! I am the walker of sky. My name is eternal. I will never die. I will go down as one of the greats, one of the ones that everyone hates. If it's the fame or if it's the infamy, I will get up to the top of the industry. This is my story, and I am the author, the story of Skywalker.